Hey guys, Julie here. I've been living in Jeju Island, South Korea for almost half a year now. And this is actually my first time going to Daiso to look at the art section. I've been resisting because I wanted to document it. Also, I didn't want to spend more money on art supplies because I already brought so many from home, but I figured it was time to, I guess, expand my collection. Ooh. Oh my lord. I tried to pick items that I actually plan to use, not just novelty items. But you be the judge as to how well I stuck to that. So Daiso here in Korea is incredible, absolutely incredible. So many of the items that I own around my home, like little things like different organizers, different holders, kitchen utensils, trash cans, things like that, all from Daiso. I feel like half of the things that I own in this apartment are from Daiso. And now a bulk of my art supplies are also from Daiso, so there's actually a Daiso closer to my place, but I decided to venture out a little bit further to go to a 7-story Daiso in the middle of the city. And as expected, the art slash office slash stationery section was massive. As you can see in the video, it had absolutely everything you could ever imagine needing. So canvases, paintbrushes, watercolor markers, oil paints, watercolors, acrylic paints, poster paints, which you will see later in this video, spoiler alert. They had fine liners in so many different colors. They had alcohol markers, easels, and of course, because it's Daiso, everything was also so affordable. So throughout this video, I got the conversion wrong of the price of everything. So when I say 2,000 won is like $2 USD or 1,000 won is like $1 USD, that is not right. As it stands, 2,000 Korean won is actually $1.66 USD. And also 2,000 Korean won is about $2.11 Canadian. So you can subtract a little bit from all of the prices that I quote because everything is actually priced a little less. Hey guys, so let's just dive right in. I have all of my items in this corner here. So let's see, first off, I have these brushes and these were 2,000 won each, which is around $2 USD. Okay, so these are the paint brushes here. And I don't really have many large paint brushes. So the one I have is this one here that I got. It's so busted. I got it from Desserts and this is my favorite brush. I forget what size it is, and as you can see where it's supposed to have the size written, it's all like peeled off because I accidentally left this brush sitting in water multiple times. They feel nice, 24, 20, and 16. And I also got these brushes here. Flat brushes, also about $2 USD. Size 16, 20, 24. So same sizes, just different styles. So I'm excited to try these because all of my brushes are quite small. I don't really have big ones, so yeah, very excited. Next we have these brush markers here. So let me show you, give you a closer look. So I got these in the calligraphy section, had my sketchbook handy. Ooh, okay, look at that. Look at that point. Okay, so I got this sketchbook from Artbox. It's just a plain sketchbook. And I did actually film a little tour of Artbox, at least the art section. If you want to watch that, I will link it down below. Ooh. Okay, so this... that's as thick as it gets. This is not an actual brush pen. It's just shaped like it, but it's more of like a sponge, which is to be expected when you're paying $1 USD for two of these guys. Oh, they also had water brush pens for 100 won, or sorry, 1,000 won, so about $1 USD. But I already have two of these. I don't really need any more, so I didn't buy them.
Okay, so I don't think that these pens, they don't look very waterproof. Oh yeah, they're definitely not waterproof. But like, it could be worse, you know? Speaking of pens, I also grabbed a 2-pack, also 1,000 won, of these pens here. They say metal nip, not nib, metal nip, name pen. Oh, here, made in Korea. So these are made in Korea, and the other pens are made in Korea. Oh, okay. It's just like a regular fineliner. Let's see how this works. Oops. Oh, I got a lot of water there. Okay, so this pen here looks like it's pretty waterproof. Look at that, there's hardly any bleed. Oh, okay, next I have this here. This is like the scratch paper, and underneath is a rainbow lay. So you scratch off the black surface and you can create an image that way. And this comes in, I think, 2 sheets. Oh, actually 3 sheets. And it comes with this wooden tool that you can use to scratch off the paper. Ooh, okay. So this paper, oh, it is really smooth. Ooh. Oh, that is fun. Look at that. There you go. Hello there. Just with my nail. Ooh, that's not a fun feeling. This is gonna be a lot of fun to play with. At first I was like, why isn't this a little bit more sharp? But I think this is good because you can get some nice thick lines, but also if you use it on its side, you can get some thin lines. So I do like that. This might be another video. We'll see. We'll see how it works out. Sometimes I film things, but it doesn't work out, so I don't end up posting it. Next, we have even more pens. So this was a crazy deal. 2,000 won, so 2 USD, for all of these colors here. Like, I love that. I think that's amazing. I should have gotten my scissors ready. Oh wait, no, I got it. That's what you do when you're too lazy to get up. Ah, it says make your world. Ah, made in China. Fineliner 0.4. Ooh. So I know a lot of people write their names when they when they get like a new pen, but I always write hello there. I don't know why. And I don't know when I started doing this, but oh, that's nice and smooth. Should probably blow on this, let it dry. There's some bleeding there. Oh yeah, that is bleeding quite a bit. The pink is holding up a bit better. Okay, so these are all the colors. And this is like such a pretty range of colors. I actually love it. I can't believe this was only like $2. That's crazy. Oh yeah, there is. Oh, there's some bleeding. Okay. Oh my god, look at this. Completely bled. Oh, and even the pink is going. You could tell, so I only put water over the hello, so you could tell the color difference. So the ink is already starting to spread. So these are not waterproof. Next, oh, I have something fun here. I have some poster colors. So there were some tubes of acrylic colors and acrylic colors, acrylic paint and watercolors, as well as oil colors. As well as oil paint, but I decided not to buy them because they looked like the typical sets that you could get from the dollar store. I don't imagine them being any different than that, or like the really cheap sets that you get from Walmart. So I put them in my cart at first and then I removed them, and I thought, you know what, I've never tried poster colors. They seem really interesting. I figured it'd be more fun to try supplies that I have never used before. That way I can experiment with it, you know? now. I really should have brought my scissors. Okay, so I just realized how gross and dry my hands look, so I put lotion on them. Sorry if y'all don't like to look at dry hands. Ooh, okay, fun! Oh my god, look at that! That's so fun! Oh god, it's because I put lotion on my hands. They're now slippery. Oh my god, okay, let me just wipe them on my jacket. That's better. Oh, okay! Hello, that is fun! Let me show you all the colors. Okay, I love that they come in like these little containers. And I am planning to get back into paint making. So I need to find, because I did bring my makeshift little muller, but I do need to find a tile that I can use to actually mull the paints on. It comes with this little plastic stick, I guess, to fish the paint out. Look at these colors! This is like a nice range. This set was 5,000 won. And let me see, is it made in Korea? Oh, made in China. Okay. You know when you just get a brush and it's kind of like stuck together and a little bit stiff? So. Ooh, look at that. That's fun.
This was actually my first time even hearing the term poster color. I had no idea what they were. I bought similar paints and containers from Brazil when I went to visit family back in 2019, but those were actually more of like children tempura paints. So I expected these to be similar, but they were completely different. Completely. So poster colors are really similar to gouache. So they dry matte, you can re-wet them. The main difference is poster colors are actually meant to be used in pieces that are to be scanned, not necessarily displayed. These colors are not light fast, they are cheaper, and the pigment particles are actually bigger than gouache. So it re-wets a little bit easily because you have less of that pigment actually infusing into the paper, if that makes sense. So the backgrounds of Studio Ghibli films were actually created using poster colors. Definitely not poster colors from Daiso. But yeah, there's a fun fact for you. So it's used in projects like that. I am very excited to play around with these. I think it'll be a lot of fun. And they do remind me of jelly gouache. So I wonder if jelly gouache is actually just a set of poster colors in disguise.
Oh, I also got this here. So watercolor paper is kind of hard to come by here in Korea. I've checked a lot of different places and they have many sketchbooks, but not really watercolor sketchbooks or watercolor paper. And it's kind of surprising. Maybe it's a translation error, I don't know. Maybe I have to try harder. But even online, like looking on Coupang, which is like the Korean Amazon, I can't really find a lot of watercolor paper and there's nothing for like super cheap. But oh, this is nice. This is a 14-page set of calligraphy paper. So this was the closest thing I could find. And it is quite thin, like compared to watercolor paper, it's a little bit thin. It does look like it could handle water, so I'm excited to play around with this. I think that'll be really good. I'm gonna leave one out. Oh, and this paper here was made in Korea. So, before we get to our watercolors, I've one more item left. And this is, I zoomed back in. This is a palette. They have these palettes everywhere. Back in Canada too, they have like the smaller version. And I think like in the past I paid like $5 for like the small plastic palette for this size of a palette. And they did actually sell the smaller ones for 1,000 won, so one USD. This big one was actually 2,000 won, $2 USD all in all. And it's like your standard, really thick plastic. And how many wells? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 28 wells, and it is such a good size. Like, I'm very, very impressed with this. I don't know if that video will be out yet. If it is, I'll link it, or whenever it's out, I'll link it to this video. But I did film a video shopping at actual Korean art stores. They're more stationery or office supply stores. So there are quite a few office supply stores here, and they do carry art supplies normally. So I did film a little bit of that, so you can watch that. And I did actually get a set of Shinhan watercolors that I haven't tried yet. Maybe by the time I post this video, I would have tried them. But yes, I am intending to film that whole process. And I did actually take footage at the shop so that you guys could see what a Korean stationery store looks like. And I actually got this palette specifically to use for those paints, so I'm planning to let them dry in here and then I'll use them just as regular watercolors. Okay, and last but not least, the piece de resistance. I totally butchered that. Okay, I got these watercolors. I don't think I've ever seen watercolors in a tube for kids because it is kind of messy. And that's why I actually bought this instead of the other watercolor tube set that I did film. I was debating on whether or not to get those. I put them in my cart, then I put them back, but I figured like the packaging of these was a lot more unique, so I thought it'd be more fun to try out. Okay, oh, so this is cool. So the lid, 3, 6, 12 wells, and a little area here for mixing, which is kind of amazing. These are the watercolors, and so many colors. This was $5. $5 for this, 5,000 won. There you go, made in Korea. 28 colors, 28 colors, $5, made in Korea. Amazing, amazing.
This set of watercolors is so much fun. There are so many bright, vibrant colors, and I'm very excited to play around with it. I kind of did a little half-ass swatch session here. I was too lazy to get up, to go to my kitchen, and I live in a studio, so like I don't even have to enter a different room to get into my kitchen. It's right there. But I was too lazy to get up, so I just worked with what I had at my desk, and that was my watercolor brush pen, the refillable ones. I just used the water in that to dilute the paint, and I put it onto the calligraphy paper that I got from Daiso, which isn't the best paper, but I mean, that's to be expected. It was only 1,000 won. But I accidentally over diluted the watercolors. So at first when I swatched some of the colors, especially that blue color, it was very faint. But yeah, I definitely went overboard there. I did notice a lot of separation between the pigment and the binder, and also the tubes did feel half empty. So I actually used these watercolors when I taught an English camp. They weren't these exact brand of watercolors, but they were in a similar tube. And those ones, I think they were higher quality because they, first of all, they felt a little bit more full. There was still some separation between the pigment and the binder, but the colors were a little bit more vibrant. I think there were less filler in them. So I'm a little bit disappointed just because I expected the same kind of consistency. But you know, you can't be too harsh on children watercolor paints purchased from Daiso, 28 for 5,000 won. Like, you really can't complain, you know? Either way, I'm very excited to play around with these, and I will save that for a future video. I just wanted to apologize for my very lazy swatch session. But don't worry, because I'll swatch them properly, I will do them justice in another video. So stay tuned for that.
This is the state of my desk. All of the supplies are just scattered. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I don't know if I'm planning to buy any more art supplies, at least not for a long time, because I feel like I'm fully stocked. And I actually really tried to control my spending. I wanted to buy a lot of items, but I resisted, and I just wanted to buy items that I would actually use, first of all, and items that were kind of unique that I thought would be interesting to watch me play around with. In total, I spent 26,000 won, so $26 for all these supplies, which is amazing because I have 28 watercolors, 12 post-it colors, I have 14 calligraphy pages, this quite a large watercolor palette, a canvas, some scratch paper, 5 of these palettes here, these disposable palettes. A bunch of pens, some brush pens, and some regular fine tip pens, and 6 paintbrushes for $26. That is pretty sweet. Like, that's a pretty good deal. Oh my god, and I totally forgot about these too. A pack of 12 fine liners. Like, oh, come on. Daiso is amazing. It's amazing. Overall, I had a really good time. I can't wait to like really dive into these. So yeah, I'm sorry I didn't properly demo the items. But, you know, stay tuned. Future videos will be out shortly. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. As usual, subscribe, like, unsubscribe, dislike, do whatever you want to do. And until next time, stay creative. Peace.